we've already removed the lock that was here before. Now we've got our screwdriver and we're ready to get started. We're going to be installing the deadbolt itself. As with other locks, it does have this twist functionality to match up to the size of the door. We want to make sure that this is vertical. And then we're going to make sure that this part is on the bottom. So insert it like so. So step three, we're going to add the front piece here. It's important that this piece is vertical, so we'll fish this through here on the bottom, of course. There we go. Line up with that hole. There we go. So that's how that's gonna look. There was a piece of adhesive there to, you know, hold this from moving around. Since we're gonna be testing other locks in this location, I've decided not to use that. Now on the other side, we've got this mounting bracket here. So that's gonna go back here. And again, with the adhesive, we are not gonna use that. There's a hole where the wire gets threaded through. We just kinda wanna line that up. Like so. As with other locks, getting it lined up is kind of a pain, but had I used the adhesive, that probably would have been slightly easier. We'll get these screwed in here. All right, we got that tightened up. Looks nice. Pretty straightforward. One of them screws into place and the other gets plugged in. It's slightly more complicated. Not a lot of space to work with. I apologize if my hands are blocking the shot. Yeah. The instructions weren't very clear, but I've determined the issue. This sensor actually goes on the outside. So there'll be a spot for it to route outwards. And now looking at it, I realize it needs to go out this way. Should just be a testament to you guys that these are real videos and we're actually doing the installation. Your experience may vary. Theory that was supposed to just line up on ice, like, but still getting stuck somewhere here. All right, so to get the wire to fit in properly. I had to wrap it around and then back. So I'm just gonna pull it back off and show you guys, because I think this is a pretty critical step. It had to go like a Z. This part had to go back and then forward again. Otherwise there's too much cord right there. It was real pain. But then once I wrapped it like that, it made this real snug. And now I'm able to just slide that on. And remember, this piece needs to stick out the side. But yeah, when I did that, then it came nice and flush. So watch for that. And that is not really explained very well in the instructions at all. So you may have reached that point of your installation and consulted YouTube to figure out how, and maybe you had the same problem as me. So hopefully that was helpful. All right, so the lock operates very smoothly. We know we've done it correctly. So the next step, we're gonna insert three batteries. I do like that they give you Energizer batteries, not some knockoff brand. Throughout the installation process, you'll notice there's a lot of these little tags that you peel and remove. Press and hold. And maybe insert the last battery. Aha! So what they don't tell you in the instructions is that you hold the button, then insert the battery, not just hold the button. Added that sensor there. Did have to break the little tabby off so there's more space. Now it comes with this door strike with this fancy plastic backing, which is pretty cool. We got a new house here, so looks like it's just fine with the one we had in there. So now that we've installed the Locklee lock, we're gonna add a new fingerprint. You do that within the app here. Now it's connected, so it says, please record the fingerprint. Right here shows how many more attempts we need to do. So right now, six. I'm gonna use my index finger. One. Go. It's counting upwards here. There we go. Now in the app, I'm gonna go ahead and name myself. Show that it was me that unlocked it. The nice thing with the Locklee is that the numbers change locations each time. So as I go to do it again, now the number one is there, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Unlock. Lock it again. And I come back, and now the locations are different. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's two fives there even, and and unlock it. So the fingerprints are going to be in different spots at each time, so it's more secure that way. And then to lock, I can just do that. To unlock with my finger, I can do that. I can use this key to unlock it as well. Otherwise, I can go through the app and lock and unlock that way, which I will show. So now, from the app there, I've locked the door. Unlocked the door. It's got this nice camera, so it's kind of blurred out when it's not in use, but now I can see there's us doing the filming right now. So one of the features of the Lockly is that it should auto-lock. We've got this sensor here. Close the door. There we go. Another feature too is it has this privacy. So you can use that to prevent people from unlocking. So very cool feature.